Healthcare is actually very, very expensive in Canada. To get a COVID test done was $398 Canadian just for them to swab your nose and put inside something and get if you're positive or negative. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, you're welcome. If you're an oldie, thank you so much for coming back. My name is Neka Izaya and you're welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm going to start from scratch so that you guys can understand what the healthcare system is like in Canada. I'm going to be dividing this video into 5 parts. The first part is going to be Medicare. That is the general overview of healthcare in Canada. The second part is going to be what's covered and what's not covered. The third part is going to be OHIP, that is the Ontario Health Insurance Plan. I specifically wanted to talk about OHIP because I'm in Ontario. Different provinces have different guidelines to their health insurance, so I'm going to be focused more on Ontario. The fourth part of this video is going to be who is covered in Ontario. The last part of this video is going to be the document you would need to apply for your health card in Ontario or in Canada in general. The healthcare system in Canada is called Medicare. It's just basically the publicly funded healthcare system in Canada. Canada has 13 provinces. Different provinces have different names they call their publicly funded insurance plan. So I'm going to be listing the names of the health insurance plans in different provinces in Canada because I know not everyone is going to be based in Ontario. So the first one is Ontario, which is where I am in right now. Their insurance plan is known as Ontario Health Insurance Plan, also known as OHIP. Then Alberta, which is known as Alberta Healthcare Insurance Plan. The third is British Columbia, which is known as Medical Services Plan of BC. The fourth is Manitoba, which is called Manitoba Health. The fifth is New Brunswick, which is known as New Brunswick. Hey, I'll just say ND, which is known as NB Healthcare before I cut my tongue. The sixth is Newfoundland, which is known as Newfoundland Medical Care Plan. The seventh is Nova Scotia, which is called Medical Service Insurance. The eighth is Northwest Territories, which is called Northwest Territories Healthcare Insurance Plan. The ninth is Nunavut, which is called Nunavut Healthcare Plan. The tenth is Prince Edward Island, which is called Prince Edward Island Hospital and Medical Services Plan. The 12th is Saskatchewan, which is called Saskatchewan Medical Care Insurance Plan. The 12th is Yukon, which is called Yukon Health Care Insurance Plan. And last, Quebec, is called Regidole Insurance something something. It's in French, so I'll just leave it on the screen right now because I cannot even stress myself. Okay, so that's the insurance plans for the provinces of Canada. So now let's go into the next part of this video, which is what's covered and what's not covered. I can remember a few videos ago when I spoke about things you should know before coming into Canada. I spoke about health insurance and I clearly stated that not every medical services in Canada is actually for free. Some are for free and some are not. So I'm going to be listing what's covered under Medicare and what's not covered under Medicare. So what's covered under Medicare? The first thing that's covered under Medicare is emergency visits, like when you go to the emergency room and you need to see a doctor ASAP. The second thing is walk-in clinic. The third thing that is covered is appointments, medical appointments with your family doctor. The fourth thing that is also covered is medical tests and surgeries. Medical tests like blood work, CT scan, MRI, things like that. So those are the things that are actually covered under Medicare. Okay, so now let's talk about what's not covered under the Ontario Health Insurance Plan. Things like prescribed medications, dental care, physiotherapy isn't covered, and prescription eyeglasses are not also covered. I can remember vividly in the last video when I spoke about the healthcare system in Canada, I told you guys that the company I work for has their own insurance plan. The insurance plan my company uses is called Manulife. So Manulife is like a private insurance. There are two different things. Private insurance companies is different from Medicare. Medicare is a government publicly funded insurance plan that covers like majority of Canadians, right? While private insurance plan are plans that you'd have to pay for. Now the company I work for, they have their own private insurance plan and they cover like a percentage of like my dental services, my eye care, things like that. So the private insurance companies kind of cover the things that are not covered by Medicare, which is the government publicly funded healthcare system in Canada. Now let's talk about who is covered. Who is covered under Medicare? Who is covered under OHIP? Not everyone is covered under OHIP. Unfortunately, international students are not covered under OHIP. I also mentioned in that same video that international students have to pay for their own insurance when they are coming to Canada. So if you're paying for your tuition fee, part of that tuition fee, you're going to have a section that says health insurance plan. Different schools use different companies for their insurance plan. Some other provinces cover international students, but not all provinces cover international students, unfortunately. So that's something you have to look at too as well. So I'm going to be telling you guys who is covered by OHIP, and I'll be referring to the Government of Canada website, okay, just in case you see me looking down. That is what I'm reading. I'm also going to leave the link in the description box so you can always check it out whenever you want to. For you to be covered by OHIP, you have to be a Canadian citizen. You also have to be an Indigenous person. They are also called Aboriginals. They are like the owner of the land, the native people of Canada. You would have to be a permanent resident. You have to have a PR card. You would have to have applied for your PR. So even if you've not been granted your PR yet, you should have to have applied for your PR before you can be covered by OHIP. You would have to have a valid work permit that offers you a full-time job or that offers you full-time hours. And that's what I'm under now. I used my open work permit to get my health card. The next thing is you have to be a convention refugee. You also have to be a clergy member before you can be covered under OHIP. That's basically who is covered under the Ontario Health Insurance Plan. So now let's focus on the next part of this video, which is getting your health card using your working permit. So when I was applying for my health card, I had to go to Service Ontario. Service Ontario is the organization or is the body that's in charge of issuing health cards to people. And before I went there, I kind of already took all the documents I needed for the process. But at that point, I just felt like I have landed into Canada. Like I just felt like I now belong in Canada. One thing I should let you guys know is that the period between after you finish school and before you get your health card is actually the most risky part of being in Canada, because you're not covered any insurance plan. When you were going to school as an international student, you were covered under a private insurance plan. When you get your work permit, you're covered under OHIP, right? So that gap is a very, very risky one. So most times they advise people to apply for a private health insurance. It's actually a very, very risky period, and you have to be very, very careful because healthcare is actually very, very expensive in Canada. Healthcare is expensive. The last vlog I posted, I told you guys that I was going for my COVID test. And as of then, I did not have my health card yet with me. So when I went for my COVID test, I went to the hospital and they asked me for my health card because I was already having my work permit, right? I didn't have my health card yet. And they billed me. To get a COVID test done was $398 Canadian just for them to swab your nose and put inside something and get if you're positive or negative. $300 and something. But I did not pay because immediately I got my health card, I just called the hospital and told them, okay, this is my health number and everything like that. So they just removed that bill from the system. So yeah, just to swab your nose and get COVID test is actually very, very expensive. So just imagine falling ill or going to emerge or getting admitted, you just pay out of your pocket. Like you just pay so much money. So that period is actually a very, very risky period, and you have to be very, very careful because it's expensive. Healthcare in Canada is very, 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 very expensive. The process wasn't hectic. I don't know, it's just quite easy for you to apply for your health card. The only thing I think that put me through a bit of stress was getting the accurate employment letter, which I finally did. It's not just a normal employment letter that you would need. There are some certain things that the Government of Canada actually requires to be on the employment letter before you're eligible to apply for a health card. All right, so right now let's talk about the documents you would need to apply for your health insurance. The first thing you will need is a photo identity. So you can either use your driver's license, you can use your passport or whatever. The second thing you need is a work permit employment letter. When you're applying for your health card, you don't have to pay any amount of money. It's for free. Like, you don't have to pay anything, which is actually very, very nice because no money is involved in this case. So now let's focus on what must be stated on the employment letter. The employment letter must have your company's letterhead. It must also be signed and dated. The letter must state that you're a full-time employee or you're working full-time hours. It must also state the title and position of your occupation. It must state that you're working within Ontario. So it doesn't really matter if the company you're working for is outside of Ontario, but the letter must state that you as a person, you are working in Ontario. It must also state the start date of your employment, and it must state that the employee, which is you, intends to work for the company for more than 6 months. And one thing you should also know is that that letter should not be photocopied or scanned. You have to get the original copy of the employment letter. Okay guys, so that's it for today's video. I hope you guys learned a thing or two, and just in case you might have any further questions, please leave them in the comment section below and I'll get to them as soon as possible. Yeah, you guys should let me know if you're in a different province in Canada. Are international students actually covered by Medicare? I'm really, really interested to know what other provinces do in terms of Medicare. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also turn on the post notification so that you can get notified every single time I upload a new video. You guys always complaining that YouTube don't used to notify you guys. So please click on the bell like button on your screen beside the subscribe button so they can get notified every single time I upload a new video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys. Bye.